Hello guys and welcome back. In this video I'm going to test the Betafly GPS rescue mode. For this I have installed a BN180 GPS module on my Armaton Rooster with the FRSky R9 Mini and the XM Plus receiver. In order to test the GPS rescue mode, I will test it first with a GPS rescue switch on my Tyrannus. After that, I will switch off my Tyrannus while I'm flying to cause a failsafe. And in the end, I will fly with the XM Plus until my receiver loses the signal. At first, let's have a quick look at my Betafly settings. On the ports tab, I have used the UART3 to set up my GPS module. On the configuration page, I have enabled the accelerometer and also the GPS module. Now we go ahead to the failsafe tab. Here I have set the throttle to hold and ARC3 to 1500 to go into the angle mode in case of a failsafe. For testing, I have set my failsafe delay to 0.8 seconds, but you better stay with the default value of 0.4 seconds. At next, at the modes tab, you see my setup of the angle mode and the GPS rescue mode on ARC3. At last, we go to the CLI tab. Here you can see my failsafe settings. Make sure to set the failsafe procedure to GPS rescue every time you have changed any settings in the failsafe tab. Well, I don't want to go on boring you with my settings. Let's go out for flying and testing the GPS rescue mode. Here on my first flight, I will enable the GPS rescue mode with a switch on my Tyrannus. For testing this, make sure to get enough satellites before you arm your quad. You also need to fly more than 200 meters away and you better keep an eye on the direction of your home arrow. By the way, don't care about my RSSI value. It comes from the R9 Mini RSSI output on channel 16 and it's not scaled correctly. So now I'm going to switch into the rescue mode. And now, as you can see, my quad is turning to the right direction and it's coming home. Switch off the rescue mode and take back control before your quad tries to land, or in other words, to crash automatically. Now we're ready for the next test. I will fly away and I will switch off my Tyrannus while I'm flying to cause a failsafe. Great, it works! And as you have seen, my quad was going into failsafe stage 1 and enabling the angle mode. After the failsafe stage delay, the GPS rescue mode kicked in. To get back control, I'm switching my Tyrannus back on. Last but not least, let's go ahead to the next test. For this, I'm switching off the external R9M module on my Tyrannus. So now there's only enabled the internal one and I only have a connection from my radio to my quad over the 2.4 GHz XM Plus receiver. Let's fly to its limits and cause a failsafe. Well, that's getting far. To be honest, I've already done this test on a previous flight and there I've got the first RX loss at a distance of around 1700 meters. Unfortunately, my DVR didn't record. Now I'm trying to cause a failsafe on a turn. And there we've got the RX loss. In this case, it also makes sense to switch your Tyrannus into the GPS rescue mode. So your quad will stay in the rescue mode, otherwise you will get back control as soon as the receiver is getting back the signal. If you rewind the scene, you will see that the signal was coming back before the GPS rescue mode kicked in. The rescue mode kicked in because I have switched my Tyrannus into it after I have seen the RX loss in my OSD. Now I keep the GPS rescue mode switched on until my quad comes back to a safe distance before I'm going to take back control. If you keep looking on the OSD, you will see that the XM Plus is losing the signal several times on its way back. For the sake of completeness, I'm showing you my GPS settings. It's not a recommendation. These are just my test settings. You will be fine with the default settings. So that's it. If you are having any questions, write it in the comments below. Thank you for watching, goodbye and see you on my next video.